I feel like everybody has a family. I mean, everybody doesn't have relatives. You may or may not have a dad or mom or whatever, but you got something or someone you're loyal to or who's loyal to you. I always heard blood makes you related and loyalty makes you family. The people I'm around, from my homies, mentors, crew, that's my family. They're my motivation.
What I'd like for you to do right now, I want you to think about your dream, because I'm in a room full of dreamers. Think about your dream right now. I want you to think about it and envision it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me share something with you. I do not believe that any of us have dreams that were not given to us for the purpose of accomplishing those particular dreams. And I want to share something with you that has changed my life. I started out, as was indicated by Jack, it's very humble beginnings. I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how far-fetched it might appear to be. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. But here's what I know. That dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. Let's say that together, please. It's possible. See, sometimes we can't say, I can do that. But what we can say, that it's possible that I can have my dream. As we run toward it, as we work on it day in and day out, no one, ladies and gentlemen, could have convinced me when I started out just over 6 years ago working on my dream. And I want you to think about whatever your dream is, because I was willing to take a chance, and most people won't do that. Most of the people that you talk to try and bring them into the business, these are not risk takers. Most people have done all that they're ever going to do. They raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning. And here's what I will share with you, that in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. In the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you could ever begin to imagine. What you will realize is that you're greater than your circumstances, that you don't have to go through life being a victim.
Thank you. takes the three-pointer from the wing.
Look at that.
Baseline, Mobley with the jumper for the tie. Now Flowers with the rebound. She puts it back up and it's in. 1 point.
Save! 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 Save!
back off to Mobley. Mobley with 43 points, takes the three-point attempt, and it's good! Three Mobley.
He even hesitated.
Brings the house down with a three-point
Star of the night time, and if you watched the game, you saw LeBron go bananas. 42 points, he was exceptional. But he did not have the biggest game in basketball tonight. For that, you'd have to go to Wilmington, North Carolina, Trask Coliseum. 42 points, you ain't seen nothing yet. Not until you see what Bree Mobley did. Sophomore guard out of Winter Haven, Florida, was 19 of 25 from the field against Delaware, 2 of 2 from three-point range, 6 of 7 from the line for a game-high, career-high, program-best, Trask Coliseum single-game scoring record, 46 points. It's the fourth highest single-game total in CAA history. We don't get UNCW, the Seahawks, on our air often. We certainly don't get the UNCW Women's Hoop Squad on our air often. But you pump in 46 in a conference win, and we take notice. Bree Mobley, my star of the night.
High for Atkins and gets it to fall. It'll be 1,000 career points for Kelva Atkins. Great moment here for the UNCW senior. She's got a career high 40 points this afternoon.
Here's to the crazy ones. The misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.